The following program contains language, images, and/or subject matter that may be objectionable to some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
Direct from Albany, New York, it's time for The Media Zone with your hosts, Ed and Dave. Tonight, a look at this week's new film and DVD releases. And the chance to win free movie tickets with the Poster Pairs game. And now your hosts, Ed and Dave!
And Dave with you. What do we have on the show movie-wise? Because we're going to try something different tonight.
You can say the names of the films because one of them is a dirty word, Ed, and I won't use it.
Dog's Purpose.
It's not that one.
Resident Evil.
Not that one.
Bastards.
Oh, that's awful.
Bastards, you could say in the 1980s during Dallas.
You could say it with the Big Valley because Heath was Tom Barkley's bastard son.
And they said it on there?
They said it. I remember being appalled at the age of, like, 5 when I watched it. Mommy, they said bastard.
I guess it's a clinical term there because...
Yes.
Actually,
When Heath and Nick were fighting, and then Nick says, "Who are you?" Because I'm Heath, Tom Barkley's bastard son.
Oh, and it was Lee Majors that said it?
It was Lee Majors.
Oh, my God.
Yep.
Shocking.
Oh, and it's still on your Comet TV, I think, is one of their Get TV or one of them.
Comet is the sci-fi channel.
Oh, then maybe it's Get TV or something else. But you'll see Laramie and Lancer and The Big Valley and the other crappy shows no one watches. Emergency, something like that.
It's funny, I was watching something on the A&E channel. It was on Ed Gein.
Oh,
on the real life murders of Ed Gein that were, you know, turned into Psycho and Texas Chainsaw. And then later that night on the Comet channel was Deranged with Ezra Cobb, the changed name. It was basically the same Ed Gein story I saw earlier, but they had to change the name.
Right.
And then when he was hooking the girl up and putting her on the ceiling, there was a blurred out spot where the nudity was.
Oh, yes, gone. Followed it up.
No nudity on the Comet channel. No. It's all clean there.
It is. Oh, it's
no HD.
No. That's
and
right.
No HD. Are those in channels in HD anywhere else? Because they don't appear to be here. They're on the upper regions. I'd like to see, you know, all the old shows they have on there in something a little clearer than we actually saw them in the 70s. I would like to see, you would think in this day and age, on the El Rey channel when they had the Knight Rider marathon. I think they were using the new Blu-rays because that looked very sharp and clear.
I wouldn't know.
But on the Comet channel, it's subpar VHS quality.
I was just watching the Twilight Zone and Three Stooges marathon.
Mm-hmm.
Which are all my favorites.
I saw only one Twilight Zone. It was the one where William Shatner was in the diner with the evil box there where you put the penny in. It tells your fortune.
Fortune, yep.
Boing. All right, now last time we were too short on the show to get to the deaths. Mm-hmm. Do you have the deaths?
No.
You don't have the deaths. They're not loaded up. Didn't we say we were going to open with the deaths for something different?
Well, he didn't believe you because you never follow through on the stuff that you say.
Well, I guess as long
you
as...
You say we're going to do the game. Let's do the game first. Let's open with the game. That's never happened.
We did do it one time and somebody didn't like it, so we stopped doing that.
Somebody. The one person who watches the show.
One person didn't like it.
So. All right, well, let's get rolling through the movies.
Let's
then we'll
do the movies then. Okay.
All right, what do we do? Who's doing first? You can do the dog.
I'll do the dog's purpose.
Yeah.
With Britt Robertson. That's not the daughter of the duck people, is it? Britt Robertson?
Britt Robertson was in another film I saw, I can't think of the name of it, recently. Hmm. But go ahead.
Josh Gad and Dennis Quaid. A Dog's Purpose shares the soulful and surprising story of one devoted dog who finds the meaning of his own existence through the lives of the humans he teaches to laugh and love. Maybe PG for thematic elements and some peril.
Oh. Britt Robertson is a fine, fine actress. At least I think it's a woman.
Who's the Robertson that was the daughter of the duck people that was on Dancing with the Stars?
What's a duck? What's a duck person?
The Duck Dynasty. She's not one of the people. Duck Dynasty. Point out the.
I don't know. I think is that that's her? Yes. That's
okay,
her.
That's not the duck woman.
Oh well, well, well. Dog knows where to go.
This is something about a reincarnated dog or something?
I believe it is. And I think there might be some group tickets available, Ed.
It probably is. That didn't work. Remember when Benji was an angel dog? That premise doesn't work.
I don't remember.
They must have forgot the Benji when he was reincarnated. I think Chevy Chase was thrown into the mix there, too.
Oh, is that Dennis Quaid? This is what his career has turned into. Maybe this film would be the one to have no dialogue.
It should. Well, people love dogs, not me in particular. And they love to see the little dog on the screen and hopefully not get hit and killed.
Well, that's true.
Look at it. There's all kinds of dogs. Oh. Rescue dogs. And
they're very heroic dogs. Yeah, look at that dog. Look at that dog.
If you love dogs and or Dennis Quaid, you may want to see this film here.
Oh, look at that. That dog did that on purpose. That kid must be a bully. Yeah, that says it all.
Something for everyone.
Move along to Resident Evil.
Oh, man.
The so-called final chapter, which stars Mila Jovovich and Ali Larter. The human race's last hope against apocalyptic obliteration is Super Soldier Alice. But she's been stripped, Ed. Stripped.
I know.
And she has no psychic powers. She must form alliances and rally survivors in Raccoon City.
Raccoon City, here it comes.
I've never seen any of these, so I was not prepared for that. For the climactic battle against the Umbrella Corporation and its ravenous hordes of the undead, this sixth installment of the video game-inspired franchise is directed by Paul W.S. Anderson, who was the man responsible for Alien vs. Predator.
Oh, that was a good one. Unforgettable.
I think when Mila Jovovich first appeared in this, she was like 18, and now she's 64.
Well, at least she was in all of these. I think Kate Beckinsale bowed out of one of the Underworld films.
She? I haven't seen any of those, so I wouldn't.
I have like a lot of these in a steel book.
Why?
When they were marked down for like $5.
Well, that makes sense.
And yet I've never watched them. Maybe I'll start watching them.
You're going to have to, Ed, because you've invested, even if you invested $2, it's money you've spent for like no purpose if you don't watch them.
Right, I have to watch them.
You must. We'll have to do it like we did the Centipede Marathon there. We'll come over and have watch six of these at your house.
I think we only saw two of those. The third one had not been made yet when we had our marriage.
I did see the third one.
You did, yeah. Yeah. I've yet to see the third one.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
I'm not missing anything.
No, you are not.
I am going to see it at some point.
But I think if you've seen the first two, you just owe it to yourself to see how bad the third one is.
I think I have to get the set of three because the second one is in color. In the set of three, but not individually. Remember, it was in black and white?
It was in black and white, yeah.
I think you should see all the poop that is spilling forth from the leakage in the color.
In glorious color.
Right.
You know, and the sign of a good film is when we're showing a clip of one film and talking about entirely different films. That's a sign of something we're really interested in.
Absolutely no interest in that Resident Evil, but I'll have to see it at some point because I will have seen the ones I have.
Because
already.
You own them.
Right. I like the cases. The cases are nice.
You buy them for the art.
The nice.
Buy them for the art and you take the disc out and throw it away.
Sometimes. But they're metal cases. I don't know why these metal cases are popular, but they are. It's a metal case. It's a steel book, but oftentimes they're dented in spots you can't see under the packaging. I don't know how that happens. You would think steel would be solid, but often there's dents from misuse by the Best Buy employees. All right, what do we have? The Bastards? The word you don't say unless it's connected to the Barclays.
That's correct.
J.K. Simmons is in this one. Owen Wilson. We've forgotten that incident from years ago, and apparently...
Everyone else has.
Bill Irwin and Ed Helms, upon learning that their mother has been lying to them for years about their allegedly deceased father, two fraternal twin brothers, that means they don't look alike,
right? That's
right.
Because that's easier for casting.
Right. They hit the road in order to find him. Rated R for language and sexual references throughout. Now, who are the brothers?
These two? Looks like that. Who is that?
That's Glenn Close, who's not in my read here.
Right. I thought so.
Oh. Now, this sounds like twins where they go out to find the father. Only they're different twins.
Let's talk about the human centipede.
Oh, no.
Oh, Terry Bradshaw.
Fine actor.
Looks
like he's playing himself as a stretch in the acting.
I think that's all he can do, though. But what was the movie? Wasn't he in a movie with Kathy Bates?
Yes, that was the Nest, Out of the Nest thing with Jessica Parker.
That wasn't the one where Kathy Bates let her her upper parts come out?
That's the one where Terry Bradshaw let his lower parts come out.
His hiney?
His hiney was on full display.
Oh, no.
The Kathy Bates one was Schmidt, I think. The Jack Nicholson?
About Schmidt,
the Nicholson thing.
All right. Do you own that one?
I think I might.
Have you seen
it? Yes, I have not watched it. And we'll have to watch it with my eyes covered, I guess. We almost got killed. Now, this is the guy from The Hangover, which I think I saw the first one under protest, and none of the other ones.
I saw the first one, and I did not see any of the other ones.
First one was so popular and made so much money and left no impression on me. I guess the kids love it. Who's that guy?
We Have the Meats. Arby's.
We Have the Meats.
Is that him doing that?
Yeah, that's him.
I didn't know that was his meats.
Yes,
that's
his meats, yes.
And potatoes. What's his name? Did we come up with his name?
Ving Rhames.
Yeah. He's the one that he gave up his award to somebody else in the audience, remember?
Yeah.
I forget who.
He got an award?
He got an award, and I think he gave it to Tom Hanks or something. He kind of just said, this guy's...
Are we doing deaths now? We got to get deaths.
We can do the DVDs, then we'll do the deaths.
All right.
And we'll save DVDs. Ornaments for the next show, I think.
Inferno.
This was just out in two fairly popular films, and then this one just tanked for some reason.
Was this part of the other...
The...
Da Vinci Code films?
Yes, the Da Vinci's. Maybe it was Felicity Jones that ruined this one.
Oh, no. Let this guy...
Yeah, this was out. We did this a while ago, but I would like to see this, even though it's got Nicolas Cage in it.
Mm-hmm.
This is the story that Quint tells in Jaws, the Indianapolis... Oh. That went down in World War II with the sharks.
Yep.
Like to see that. Maybe he gets eaten early.
Oh, David Bowie, the man who fell to earth.
I've never seen this.
Neither have I. He's been dead a year. So has Alan Rickman, who I think is a great loss.
A lot of loss in that 2016. Yeah, that was indeed. A bad year. And we're going to go over the end at the end.
Alan Rickman.
Does anybody remember this TV series?
I do.
I'm sure all the couple of fans of it will enjoy that it's coming out now.
Yeah.
I think 10 years after John Ritter's been gone, right?
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
But now his series is coming out that was thought to be lost.
Well, they were wishing.
I don't think I've seen this.
I have not.
This is where Audrey Hepburn is blind and in the apartment with two people breaking in. I assume it's Alan Arkin and Richard Crenna.
Well, if she's blind, she does not have to wait until dark.
I think she waits until dark. That's when she gets the upper hands on them.
Because she is used to it.
Although, is she holding a match up? Is that what's going on? Not sure what that's all about. She can't see that.
Don't Breathe movie that just came out.
Yes, with the blind guy. That was stolen.
Stolen, Ed.
From Wait Until Dark. You watched that one. How was that?
It was very good.
It was a good one.
Oh, no. Bob Hope.
From the archives.
Boy, did I.
Boy, hey, boy. I got to tell you, boy. I got to remember
tell you, boy.
That Elky Summer. I don't know if I can do my Bob Hope anymore. It's been so long since.
I'll retire.
I got to tell you, that Elky Summer is something else. Phyllis Diller.
Nice to see an old film nobody's seen from the 60s back out, though.
What did I go wrong
about? It's got a blue phone and a pink one. Which one is the wrong number? The blue one.
We would hope.
That's Tiny Tim is on that one, I'm sure. Boy, I got a wrong number. That Tiny Tim, boy. All right.
Well, I'm glad to be out here in old Vietnam.
I got to listen to him again. I had a good Bob Hope impression for a while, but it's gone now.
Wow. As you age, your voice changes, Ed. You can't do the same thing.
I haven't thought about Bob Hope in about 4 years, so that'll go away.
I'm still watching some good old films on TV.
Which ones are those?
Well, what did I watch recently? Arsenic and Old Lace and The Bishop's Wife. Hmm. One of my holiday favorites.
That was remade with
Denzel Washington and
Whitney Houston.
Yeah, and I think it was not called The Bishop's Wife. It was called something else. Preacher's Wife.
Ah.
But The Bishop's Wife is the original with Cary Grant, Loretta Young, and David Niven. A nice, fine Hollywood fare to get you off of that bad Hallmark.
Oh, jeez. Did you watch a lot of that or any of the new ones?
The Hallmarks?
The Hallmarks?
I saw a few new ones this year, but... You know, they're all the same, but I do like to watch them. I cry, Ed.
Oh, you don't cry at those.
I'm very sad.
I cry at how far the actors have come.
It's bad when you see Ed Asner doing it, and the best look he can give the camera is one of these.
Oh, no.
Hey, well, we got to find where he went. I think I have an idea.
You play Popeye's Pappy now with the eye.
Oh, kind of name is olive oil. Sounds like a lubricant.
After that Ed Gein special was on, they were doing one on the Amityville Horror. And that's an unusual voice to be narrating this thing. And
who was it?
Ed Asner.
Was it Ed Asner?
A recent special, apparently, from the grumbling.
Oh, God, that does look awful. All right, deaths.
Deaths.
This is so sad, Ed. How long is this?
Dave will be playing Logan in the new Wolverine movie coming. Old Man Logan. There was a few. We had some big ones in December. And then as we go through, there were some lesser ones that were interesting.
Alan Thicke, also known as America's father, despite being Canadian.
Right.
From Growing Pains.
And a ruptured aorta, very descriptive, from doing what was it?
Or in this case, an uptured aorta.
Whoops.
Because there's
an R got cut out somehow there.
It's an uptured aorta. He was playing hockey with his youngest son. And
don't play hockey when
was felled.
69.
And told his son, take a picture. I'll be fine. And then that was that.
That wasn't the one that sang the blurred lines. He was
playing
hockey.
That's his son. No, his other son, Robin. This was playing with his youngest son. I think it was 17 or 18.
Of course, when you have kids, when you're 50-something or whatever.
Margaret Whitten, there you go.
This was a surprise.
Oh, Ed, the upper left. Come on.
What? That's her current look.
Yeah, but you don't have to show that. Show her in her heyday.
Which was actually her...
in Major League over there.
Current look was a little better than she was in Secret of My Success. What was that hair she had going on there?
I don't remember her hair being like that in that
it's
movie.
It's like the Rosanna Dana.
I've seen that movie, and I don't remember her hair being like that.
She was playing the very horny aunt there, who was after Michael J. Fox.
Yes.
And I don't remember, I saw Major League once, and apparently she was in that.
Yes, she was. Oh, I didn't catch this one, did I?
I don't think you did. This was another rare
Is that the same picture side by side down there? It looks like two different guys.
Well, I'll tell you what this is here.
What is that?
I always got these two guys mixed up in the 70s. They were always on the same sitcoms and Barney Miller, $6 Million Man. It was Terry Kaiser, who's the one right there. He was in Weekend at Bernie's. He was Bernie.
He's still alive, though, isn't he?
He is still alive.
He's the guy in the lower right.
Terry Kaiser right there.
And on the far left. Oh, they're together on the far left.
They were both in, these two guys I always got mixed up, were all both in Weekend at Bernie's.
Okay.
One was Bernie, and the other guy was a mob guy or something.
Terry Kaiser was Bernie.
Right.
How do you get them mixed up? They don't look the same.
Well, when you don't have the IMDb in the 70s, and this guy, I think it was the eyes and the hair.
Oh, man.
That was Don in the Barney Miller, right next to the Terry Kaiser.
Yeah.
And when you would see one guy on Barney Miller and then the other guy on the $6 Million Man in 2 weeks, you said, geez, that looks like the guy was on Barney Miller a couple weeks ago. And I always got him mixed up.
All right.
But now we know who's who because one's gone. Hey. They'll never be mixed up again.
Oh, Bernard Fox.
Is that his laugh?
Yep.
Who is he? Dr. Bombay on Beavis?
Yep.
He was the magical doctor, right?
Oh, yeah. He was he was on Hogan's Heroes. Did he ever show up on, maybe not. I was thinking Gilligan's Island. He may have.
Did a lot of 60s and 70s TV.
Bernard Fox.
He was on Family Affair, too.
Oh!
This was another shocking one on...
Christmas Day.
Christmas Day. Another heart failure day.
Yep.
These hearts should last longer than 53, shouldn't they?
Well, they should, but it depends on what you do to your heart.
Was he doing any sort of drugs?
I don't know, but I heard reports.
This is suspected, of course.
He dabbled in some drugs, from what I heard. But I heard he's also, his weight fluctuated greatly, which can put a great strain on your heart.
Hmm.
I just decided I'm just going to stay fat.
Which was your favorite of the George Michael songs listed
None
here?
Of them.
I kind of liked I Knew You Were Waiting For Me, the one he sang with Aretha Franklin.
I don't know that song.
And everybody always hated that, Wake Me Up Before You Go Go. Oh, geez, not this again, because they played it so much. Yeah. But by the end of it, you were singing, Wake Me Up Before You Go Go. Of course, he was outed, Dave.
He was outed the minute he made a video. He was outed.
As soon as he came out on his picture on the right, he was outed.
Come on. Oh. Which one is he? Is he the one in the middle? Okay. George Irving.
He did the voice of the Heat Miser. Mm-hmm. And this one on the right, he was in All in the Family. I remember one time I heard that voice, like, my God, that voice sounds familiar. And this is when we did have the IMDb. I said, that's the Heat Miser.
And what was he in Underdog?
Wally Cox, too.
He was probably one of the villains, I would imagine.
Simon
I don't think he was Simon Barr. I don't know which one he was. We'll have to look that up. Another heart. These should last longer
He's
than...
He's 94! He should last longer than 94?
These hearts aren't lasting.
Oh, well, here you go. Here's a young heart that went.
Yeah, that was shocking, Dave.
So where's the awful picture of her? Didn't want to do that?
Actually, there was some. Well, she was just heavier at times.
She looked older than her mother at points.
We'll see that in the next picture.
Right.
But it was two things were shocking about this. Go back to Carrie Fisher. She deserves more than 2 seconds of time.
Why? She did what? For one movie?
She did the 3 Star Wars.
Okay.
And this younger picture's from about the Shampoo era. She was in that.
Okay. She was in Blues Brothers.
Blues Brothers. And I was just reading. Geez, the time is up. See?
All right, let's get going.
I think we got to go back. Let me finish up Carrie Fisher. And then there's a couple more after there. We'll have to do them next week.
All right.
I can't believe the time. Go back to Carrie Fisher. She's an icon from the 70s. I mean, she keeps getting... I'm not done with my two boob stories about Carrie Fisher.
Okay, go ahead.
In the one shampoo, the costume designer came up to Warren Beatty and said, should she wear this outfit with or without a bra? So he goes, what does she have on now? The bra. Okay, do it the other way. She comes back. Braless. Okay, we'll go with the braless. And then she's in Star Wars, and she's got the white outfit on, and she has a bra, and George Lucas can see the bra through the thing. And he says, you can't wear a bra. There's no brassieres in space. So she had to take the bra off, and you can see her as she's marching down the hallway there. She's bouncing all over the place. So we'll have to finish up some more deaths. There's a few more after that.
Okay.
Even.
All right. It's game time?
Where did the show go?
You're talking about dead people. The next show is going to be all about half dead. You okay there?
Yeah, I'm ready to get up and give away some tickets.
Don't ruin your microphone. All right, it's a poster pairs game, folks, where I'll wait for Ed to finish taking a drink.
Oh, that's good water.
Oh, delicious water. Well, there he goes. Will you send in...
I tried to be quiet. Damn thing is down there.
Okay, you've sent in two numbers via email from 1 to 6. We select your entry, reveal what's behind the two numbers you provided, and if they match, you win 2 free movie passes. And if you're right, spin the wheel, you can win up to 10 tickets. Like last time, Michelle won 4.
There you go.
And here you go, Ed. Mix up that massive amount of entries.
Wait, what were we doing on this show? It moved along. This show moves along so fast, Dave, when you're watching it.
Well, when you have something to talk about. All right, who we got? Who we got? I can't open this. David Matheson. 2 and 4. And spin.
Okay, we started out the shows this year with a winner.
Right.
And an upgrade.
2 and 4.
And it was from that last time. Are we going to do it again?
I think we are, Ed.
Oh, we're not. Not this time. You can't win everything.
Well, you can't. I mean, you can.
You can.
It just doesn't happen.
Don't forget this. The next to each other. This is an odd ploy here. The other ends. This one you'll never get. The 1 and the 5. That's a toughie.
It is a toughie. There's no rhyme nor reason for it. All right. Well, if you want to enter to possibly win some movie passes, just send an email to MediaZone95@gmail.com. That's MediaZone95@gmail.com. And if we select your entry and reveal what's behind the two numbers you provided and they match, you win 2 free movie passes. And if you say spin the wheel, or at least write it, then we will spin the Schwinn bicycle tire and you can win up to 10 tickets in total. Or you could lose both of the ones you want. It's a risk you must be willing to take.
I was just thinking, they have the Kong movie coming out.
Ooh, Skull Island.
Skull Island, then they're going to have King Kong versus Godzilla. Mm. I think King Kong should be represented again up in the House of Frankenstein. Maybe not with the version we have.
You think he'll want it back?
He may want it back now. I think they need a new version.
Well, when's that Godzilla? And that's going to be like 2019
or
something.
That'll be after. I don't know when Skull Island is in the spring.
I heard March.
Yeah.
But I think that might be pushed farther away.
Of course, if that bombs, then there's no plans for King Kong and House of Frankenstein again.
Right.
All right, we'll see you next time. We'll finish up with the deaths, and we'll see if we can get to the new Hallmark ornaments, which will be almost time for the new ones to come out by the time we get to it. That usually happens for some reason. A lot going on in January. But we'll see you next time.
The Media Zone. Able 2000 Productions.